making art is always for expressing myself. True art activity, artistic activity, is always a wonderful experience. Because there was this physical event took place in life, which we all have a different, you know, a set of things happen around. But at the same time, this physical activity or event provide also the engagement of our soul and our spirit. It all happened at the same time. So there was this part of ambiguity that fascinated me about. The spiritual side in this whole artistic expression was the whole visual investigation on what's my soul level and how I engage with my spiritual self. Water is a very abstract element for me, and yet it's a very dynamic and interesting. It's not tangible fully, and you can change in different form and under different temperature. And then our nature is filled with water, and our body is also filled with water. It's a certain level of similarity there. You see, every liquid part inside us is salty, except our saliva, as well as the seawater cover the whole earth. Something very mysterious about the water. But when I get angry, I will go and take bath also, which we all do. Or someone very thirsty, you know, I always feel I want to go and drink a mug of hot water. But many times my family member will drink cold water. I need hot water somehow, rather than cold. Maybe it's age or maybe it's personal preference. So that water element became very significant for the moment now, because maybe I have an inner, you know, a thirst for something. And in paradox to the inner fear, so that collision has happened inside me. What's actually the most fear in me as life, you know, goes by? And what is so abstract and ambiguity in there? So I want to find out what actually ails me in along the way. Drowning experience has haunted me that I can't really go into the swimming pool, or the temperature. It's always that kind of temperature soaking in your body, but our body will adjust to the temperature. It's like if I make mistake, if I do wrong things, or whatever outside me activity that I was tempted to do, which is not right to do. It's like the water around in the swimming pool around me, or seawater, and then eventually my body will adjust to immerse into it, sort of the balance between it. So it's like human. And then it's like experience you're in under the water. It's like this creature that can breathe under the water, and then you can go up to the ground. But you don't quite belong to each one. So the water in the water experience and surrounding by the water is, some people feel very, very relaxed and very wonderful, because you experience no weight almost. No pressure. But my experience at the first, you know, with the water was drowning experience. At the seaside where muddy and all the experience. And come to this time now, this experience, the muddy water is like everything that happened around us, which is so muddy. I feel that a lot of time we are sinking and immersed in the muddy water, and then we can't get out, but we have to continue breathing, you know, and we also cannot die. So there's a paradox there. So there's a desire in my soul that I wanted to get out of this water, but also there was something unquestionable about that's right to do. but there was a thirst, there was an inner thirst. Like you know, our human organism, when you thirst, you demand more water. But the more water you drink, you actually get more thirsty. So this thirst is unquenchable. And I don't know what happened, you know. So things that we do, say for example, you know, that water experience of a swimming is wonderful. But the more you swim, and you find out actually it brings some damage to your body when you swim too much, or anything you go beyond or certain depths in the water, you can't breathe, or you need equipment to help and all things like that. So at this time I question that elements, and that process bring me to a trauma. I think engaging with your own trauma, where I tangle from, and then I untangle from there. Not necessarily have an answer, but to confront it is very important, so you resolve it along the way, or you let it go. See, there was an implication in my experience with this water, and the empowerment is along the process where I do all things, questioning and then researching, and then I work it out. Certainly it's an empowerment process, but this empowerment is basically is bring to the overcoming. The overcoming on the fear, the trauma, but also expecting it brings a new experience to look at the old problem. And then we all have a list of obstacle listing, you know, obstacle of this and that. The first, I engaging with the deeper manner of the water, where the well of a Samaritan woman, and she prayed for water, and she was asked to give the water to the Creator. So that process on how water relates to a personal thirst, that process gave me a lot of thought awakenings, and then I then start to have engaging with who I am and what am I doing. Yeah, that's empowerment, is empowering the whole process on the search and seek, you know. I think that's necessary. See, when I do art, I don't think about I'm going to be a big philosopher, because everybody is a philosopher. As soon as we make a statement, a decision, in small or in large manner, I only have one purpose, to find out what's wrong with me so that I can live a better life and I can live in the right path, to minimize my mistakes, to leave a good legacy. So if you say whether it has gone through this, to my art, and I want to call the world to change, I think it wasn't my first intention. It's more on me to change. So whether this artistic activity has actually bring any process to the other, certainly I hope so, where it brings some engagement, you know. I always tell my children, keep the relationship, lose the war when you have argument with people, because the relationship will keep the conversation going, and the relationship will also give the engagement of everything, and the war is also necessary because it creates the engagement. It just and a different level of engaging, whether you want to engage it with fighting or you want to engage it with a dialogue, you know. So making art is a form of a dialogue to myself, and then engage with people. So I think dialogue is very important at this time, and whole process has to be brutally honest. I hope my art activity, with that this rustic achievement, everyone can share a little bit on some level of nourishment, also perhaps some visual transcending experience, you know, by just merely looking at the landscape or the water, but perhaps what thirst is all about.